Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. Quick disclaimer at the beginning here, I have not been covering War Thunder content on the channel for about a month, nor have I even been playing the game as well. There are reasons for this and I would like to go over them in a nice big well-formed discussion video that I'm going to be releasing hopefully sometime tonight or tomorrow. That being said, I don't like the idea of missing these dev blogs, and I apologize that I am the latest to get to them. But, like I said in my previous video on the Belfast, even if I'm late, there are some people that watch these videos not for the news, but instead for my opinions on the vehicles. And thus, I would like to go through these one by one for the first time on my own, and, of course, catch up on what I've fallen behind on. Starting with the very first proper dev blog for update 1.95, which is going to be this year's final major update for December of 2019, and that is our first look at what I believe to be the Swedish Reserve fighter aircraft. I don't know, actually. Hold on, let me make sure, because I don't want to sound like an idiot. Okay, it does not say that it's, at least from what I can tell, it does not say that it's specifically the reserve, so do not take that with a grain of salt, I should say. Because I don't want, oh, it says right here, reserve. Okay, no, my bad. This is the reserve aircraft. All right. Now, reserve aircraft, or should I say reserve, I got a message when the dev blog released, because I didn't do the video. This was, of course, a few days back. This was released on November 27th. And that message had said that they thought I was always interested in seeing reserve vehicles. And that is true. I am. Tier 1 is a bit of a mixed bag for me in the game for ground forces specifically. Because, well, for a whole bunch of different reasons that we don't need to go into here. But I really do enjoy looking at reserve aircraft more so than that of reserve tanks. And because I think aircraft don't suffer from the same issues at reserve tier that ground forces does. And the other reason is because I am a sucker for biplanes. I think biplanes are gorgeous aircraft. They come from the tail end of probably one of the greatest innovations of our time, and to see different warplanes that have more than one set of wing is great. I would love to see some tri-wing designs in the game too, but maybe we're talking a little too early. However, this is the J6B2. I am not going to say that because you cannot pay me enough money to try to pronounce some Swedish shit. This is, it looks, just on the surface, the first thing I think of when I see this is a gladiator, but it's clearly not, because it looks to only have two machine guns, and if I read that correctly, did it say 8mm machine guns here in the video? Yes, 8mm machine guns, which I think is a new caliber, is it not? Well, we'll find out. As you may already know, a full Swedish aviation tech tree is coming with War Thunder Major Update 1.95. Swedish aircraft will gradually be added to the game during a beta test period, and players who have purchased early access packs will get the chance to research all the Swedish aircraft as soon as the update releases. This is the J6B2 fighter. It's a reserve aircraft for Sweden of rank 1. Pros are that it has great handling characteristics. I would expect nothing less from a biplane, unless it's the PO2, and large choice of machine gun ammo belts. That's curious. I wonder what they mean by that. So I guess it's not the just classic universal default tracers and stealth that you always get on pretty much everything for machine guns, especially down at low tiers. So I'll be interesting to see what exactly they're meaning there. The cons, however, that has average speed near the ground and weak armament. This is also something that I'm generally used to with reserve aircraft. They're not fast most of the time. The armament, however, is subjective because a lot of the reserve aircraft in War Thunder, I think every nation has their own powerful reserve plane. I mean, for example, back in the day, there was no denying it, the Russians had ridiculously overpowered reserve aircraft. I don't think they're as bad anymore. They've definitely been nerfed into the ground compared to how they used to be. But the United States was always interesting. People always shat on the P-26 pea shooters because, well, they're clunky, and why would you fly those over a biplane? Well, people forget that one of the pea shooters has a 50 caliber machine gun, and that's what separates the U.S. reserves from all the other nations. Germany, I think, has a good mix. Their HE-51s are, they're a solid balance, I think, of maneuverability, weaponry, speed, and all that kind of stuff. The Russians, they have 4 machine guns, so obviously they have a butt ton of ammunition they can just throw away. You know, even when the French came to the game, I thought that they were also a really interesting reserve set of aircraft, because they had, they had a very early, like, monoplane almost designed to them, and they got a 20mm cannon. Of course, with its own downsides, limited ammunition, slow fire rate, of course, all that kind of stuff. The Italians, I still think, are probably some of the best reserve aircraft in the game, at least if it's anything like when they released back in the day, because they had a biplane, you know, that had 4 machine guns, was very maneuverable, had high speed, they could put fires out instantly, and they also had an attacker as a reserve, which had 250 caliber machine guns on it, well, Italian 12.7mm, should I say. A gunner and all that kind of stuff, and could carry bombs, you know, a proper bombs that could actually do something. So, yeah, I'd love to see what the reserve aircraft in War Thunder looked like. And this thing, not that exciting compared to others, but at least it stands out from the crowd in that it has 8mm machine guns, which is new to me. So here's some screenshots of the aircraft. I think it looks great. Like I said, I'm a sucker for biplanes. What the hell is that? Is that a gun? That's not a gun, is it? Sticking out of the ass end of this thing? I hope that's... Because if that's a weapon, I'm gonna cream. Here's some history on the aircraft if you wish to see them. Whoops, I didn't mean to do that. Okay. So the J6B... 2 is a classic biplane fighter of the pre-war period. The aircraft was partially covered with metal and fabric. The cockpit was open, and the powertrain was a British radial 500 horsepower Bristol Jupiter engine. The J6B is armed with a pair of 8mm Swedish-made machine guns, a licensed copy of the Browning M191. What? M1919? I don't know why I said M... Son of a bitch. With a new caliber, so very curious, learning something new. Due to its less-than-impressive engine, the J6B's speed near the ground is fair to average. However, its maneuvers well even at... What? No, it maneuvers well even at low speeds. Okay, I keep reading that wrong. Here we got another shot of the aircraft. Fun fact, a couple of J6Bs were supplied to the Finnish Air Force, and those aircraft were used as training vehicles right up to 1945. Now, since the Swedish tech tree is going to be reserve, is going to be closed beta test, I mean, to people that own the packs and stuff, I'm curious to see what they're going to make the, you know, tier 1 premium, because every nation gets a tier 1 starter premium, and most nations, it seems like, at least back in the day, they never gave you a reserve premium. Like with the ground forces, it's always a carbon copy paste of the reserve tank, right? Almost always, at least. Or what used to be the reserve tank. Like, for example, Germany no longer has the Panzer IIc as a reserve tank. But back in the day, it was the reserve, and thus the premium starter was a Panzer IIc. But with aviation, it's always like a different rank one, right? Like a battle rating 1.3 or, you know, up to 2.0 range aircraft. Like the Russians have a Chaika starter, you know, the Italians have the CR-42, the Germans used to have the CR-42 as their starter premium. So I'd be curious to see what the Swedish starter is going to be, and if it's going to be another Finnish plane, because as we know, apparently they are combining Finland and Sweden together, which implies that we'll have, I don't know if we're going to have Finnish aircraft on the standard tree. I would imagine we will. But we already know that one of the current premiums for the Swedish tech tree is a Finnish plane. The J6B is a good in-game starter aircraft for players of Sweden. It's a good choice for playing in lower-ranked sandbox matches. I have never heard that term before. How long have I been away from War Thunder? What the hell's a sandbox match? Allowing players to earn their first victories and Silver Lions for researching new starter rank aircraft. The J6B's level flight speed is relatively low, so it's best to gain altitude away from major dogfights. It sports 2 guns in total, but the pilot has a wide choice of ammunition, including incendiary, armor-piercing, and tracer rounds. Okay, that sounds not much different to what I'm used to. I was expecting a larger boast of options. Got a nice side shot of the aircraft. It looks like it's of course a classic biplane with the landing gear always in the stuck position. I wonder if they're ever, well, I just realized how stupid what I was about to say was going to be, so nope, I'm not going to say it. You will never know. Players will find the Swedish aircraft will prove their worth as interesting and unique war machines. Stay tuned to our developers' blogs and articles and all that crap. I didn't mean to go down. So yes, this was the first official 1.95 dev blog, and there are many more that I'm going to be covering over the course of the next handful of videos. But if you are very excited for the Swedish aviation tech tree coming to the game with the next major update, feel free to let me know in the comments down below, or if you are more interested in seeing the Swedish ground forces, or apparently even the Swedish naval forces, feel free to let me know about that instead. I personally, while I'm interested in seeing what unique Swedish aircraft are coming to the game, am, well, a lot more interested in Swedish tanks.